or I will after this.
Greetings, ladies and gentlefish, and welcome to... where's my colorblind mode gone? There we go. Welcome to a trio of games. They're my games. But the point here is that none of none of these ships. I've just recorded a World of Warships video. Oh, God. None of these tanks are fully upgraded. In fact, the first two are very stock. And the third one is only not quite so very stock, really by virtue of the fact that there isn't much to upgrade on that particular machine. So, we're starting off with the SU-101. This is the Tier 8 Soviet tank destroyer, the one that isn't the ISU-152. We're using the gun from the SU-100M1, except it's worse on this, so you get the same 175 penetration, 250 alpha damage, but your accuracy goes to pot, which is kind of sad. Also, your ammunition count is terrible. I mean, seriously, 36 rounds with a 100mm gun doing 250 alpha damage on a Tier 8 tank destroyer? Yeah, not great. Anyway, Jagdpanzer 4 has decided that he doesn't like life anymore, although I flubbed the shot. Maybe he does like life. Who knows? And we're top tier, of course, which helps. There we go. And one more will finish this guy off. Looked like he might have been tracked. There we are. And he's dead. We're top tier, which helps. We don't have the top engine. In fact, we may not even have the intermediate engine at this point. I can't remember. I can't remember about the suspension. This is a pretty stock machine. So don't expect great things, but I like to do these occasional videos where I play machines that aren't fully upgraded, because it just shows people that you can still do alright, even in machines that aren't fully upgraded. They're never going to outperform a fully upgraded tank, but you can still do okay. ARL-44, there we go. He's got the stock turret, poor guy, that massive barn on top of his tank that's terrible and really easy to penetrate, and he has now been put out of his misery. So this, I should point out, this is an assault game. We're on the defending team on the Siegfried line, and this is patch 9.7, so I think this is before they changed this map, and especially out on the field, it's where a lot of the changes were seen. So we're losing this 2-3, great, fun, and we're just trying to find a place from which we can put this gun to some good use. Now, we've only got 175 pen, the accuracy is not particularly good. So ideally, we want to be putting shots into either lower tiers or into people's sides and rear. I do have 10 rounds of APCR if it's necessary. Hello, Mr. Panther, how are you today? Oh, Black Prince picks up the kill. Super Purging picks up the kill before I'm able to land the shot. And with APCR, the penetration jumps up to 235. But it's expensive as all hell, and I don't think I use any in this game, although I could be wrong. Lerva should hopefully not be long for this world. There we go, he's been taken down by our IS-2, and there's also a Centurion over here. Ooh, IS-2's on fire. Now, I don't want to go out there too far, because I don't want to take shots in the side from that T-34. Never mind, the 112, as that would hurt. Type 59, oh dear, now this is where premium ammunition would actually be useful. I'm actually surprised my first armor-piercing round actually manages to penetrate his lower plate. I load to APCR and put that into the side of his turret and then switch back to armor-piercing. And just keep a look over there in case he decides he wants to poke out some more. So yeah, I was surprised that my 175 average pen got through his lower plate. Maybe it was a high penetration roll. See if I can do something about this 112. 112 has just fired and has a horrible reload time, and he's on fire and he's dead. Never mind. Was aiming at the lower plate because the 112's lower plate is made of cheese and fuel tanks, which is not a particularly good combination. Who'd have thought? Type 59, there's the guy from earlier on, he's on 139 health. Ooh, AMX-AC-46, might be able to put some shots into him. And also the Stuart ML to my right. And the Black Prince, now, Black Prince's frontal armour is 152mm thick. I have 175mm of average penetration. He can certainly hurt me, I can definitely hurt him as long as I'm careful with where these shots go. Nah, that probably didn't go quite where I aimed it. Black Prince has taken a little bit of a pasting. Oh, AMX AC-46, into the weak point. Ow, that hurt. Black Prince only damages my tracks, thankfully. Although I think that was actually an APCR round that I'd readied for the Black Prince. 5 minute warning. Because penetrating his front is entirely possible with 175 penetration, but especially with the dubious accuracy, it's not guaranteed by any stretch of the imagination, and I didn't want to just die. AMX AC-46 is still looking this way, which is fine, that just means the 110 can plough him from behind. There's also the Type 59 there. He's also looking this way, which is fine for the same reason. And they've suddenly decided this is bad. They're going to get outflanked. Black Prince is now dead. There's a tiger around here somewhere as well, an enemy tiger. There we go, there's the AC-46. He doesn't really know which way to look. Can't really say I blame him. And I could probably pop out and put some shots into him right about now. Ooh, if the Type 59 is just going to go backwards, though. Yep, we will nail that kill. And the AC-46 is also taken down, and that just leaves their artillery and their Tiger. And you can see that, you know, I haven't been firing these shots willy-nilly, but I'm down to 11 rounds of armor-piercing, 8 rounds of APCR, and 5 rounds of HE. 5 rounds of HE is probably a bit too much, if we're going to be honest. Especially given the limited ammo count that you get. Tiger's been spotted. I was thinking of going to try and nail the enemy artillery, which I'm still thinking of doing, hence I've got the high explosive loaded. Can't remember exactly how much health the M44 has, but its armour sucks, so yeah. Their Tiger nails our VK3002M. I mean, the 110 should be able to nail the Tiger, but then again our 110 is low health, so maybe going after the artillery is not the smartest move here, I don't know. We shall see. But that's what I'm doing. Where is he? Well, I haven't spotted him yet, and he hasn't shotgunned me yet, so... I mean, this is the thing. He could be up by their spawn point number one. I might be entirely wasting my time here. I can't actually remember. So we're just going to speed this along a little bit. Till I find him. Oh no, there he is. And this is where we have a fight with my epic gun depression. The gun depression on this tank is really bad. Their Tiger is dead. M44 has 280 hit points. If I can just find the gun depression... Oh, I miss, he misses. Means that I should be able to aim this next shot. And 262 damage roll. What's the average damage from HE rounds? 330. So that was unlucky. But I managed to finish him off with a ram. And that was the game. Hurrah. Let's go and take a look at how well it went. So it was a second class mastery, fire for effect. I think that's Master Gunner and Bruiser. We came third on our team for experience with 957 base XP, 2,315 damage, and those three kills. 14 shots fired, 11 hits, 10 pens. Most of that damage was at relatively close range, which is unusual for that sort of tank destroyer, but it does occasionally happen. 4 hits received, of which one didn't penetrate and the rest did, so there's the armour for you. 773 assistance damage, and despite firing a round or two of APCR, we still made 24,000 credit profit, and even with a standard account, we'd have made just under 10,000 credits. It was a x5 experience weekend, so that was quite tasty indeed. And there we go, let's move on to game number 2. So the second game, we're driving the stock KV-4. This is the one of the tier 8 Soviet heavy tanks. You can see stock turret, 122mm gun. I mean, yeah, this is not a very happy tank at the moment. And we're on Prokhorovka, or is he fiery salient? It's Prokhorovka. They're the same thing, basically. Which is a very open map and not the sort of map the KV-4 likes. And it's a tier 10 game. Oh, Christ. The only saving grace here is that there isn't actually any artillery in the game. I think my worst ever, or most painful game in the KV-4, it was stock. It was on Overlord. It was a tier 10 game, and there were 10 artillery in the match, 5 per side. That was about as fun, and the KV-4 did about as well as you could imagine. That was horrible. As I say, this, we at least don't have any artillery. As for everything else, tier 10 game, although there's only one tier 10 on each side, the enemy's tier 10 is an IS-7, but I am going to meet him. Tier 10 game, big, wide open map, stock, tier 8 heavy tank, especially the KV-4. Yeah, it's not sounding particularly good. I'm going to speed it up initially because the KV-4 is incredibly slow. But I'm just coming up to this region here. My logic is that, if you're in a heavy tank, this is not a bad place to go. It allows you to put in crossfire across the map. In fact, this is a spot I quite like in a medium tank as well. It works better if your tank has gun depression, and the KV-4 kind of doesn't, but can't have everything. Remember the IS-7? Yeah, he's just in front of me. Woohoo. Now notice I am packing quite a lot of high explosive ammo with this tank. That's entirely intentional. The ammo count is fairly respectable. Bounce on him, what a surprise. And the 122mm high explosive ammo is actually pretty good. Ooh, he got wrecked. And I'm pretty sure that's my assistance damage. And he's dead. So the enemy KV-4 had a pretty sour time of things. Bounce the Conqueror. So yes, I'm reasonably generous ammo capacity on the KV-4. 122mm high explosive ammo is not too good. I mean, the APCR on this is not particularly great. 122mm high explosive ammo is not too shabby. So I've got 10 rounds of it. And I think I used them all in this game. Anyway, I apologise there, because I didn't mean to block the KV-3. So yeah, IS-3, can we get a shot into his flank? Not really. No, it's a little awkward. And that's really going to be the the bottom line of this game. It's a little awkward. So T-32 has been spotted. There's also a Patton and a T-54 over there. We're going to have to be very careful about cresting any of these ridges because our gun depression sucks and we could take an awful lot of pain to the face. Which would suck. So, our tier 10. Where is our tier 10? Our tier 10, our Jagdpanzer E100, is sitting at K2. Now, I appreciate that he's in a tank destroyer, but he would struggle to be any further back if he tried. Tiger 2, Tiger 2, Tiger 2. Can I get a shot into the Tiger 2? Yes, I can. It's a low damage roll. But it's damage, and in this sort of game, I'm happy with damage. So 319 into him. In fact, I think that's towards the bottom end of what I could possibly roll for damage, but there we go. No, I think I can roll slightly under 300 at worst. There's the IS-7 again, oh dear. Enemy IS-3. Also not looking great. And I get spotted. Enemy Tiger 2. Can I plump another shot into him? Trying to pick out his turret roof. I know sniping at range with this gun never going to work. But the turret roof on the Tiger 2, although it's heavily sloped, it's only 40mm thick. So this 122mm gun can overmatch it, and thereby making it a relatively large weak spot for this gun. I mean, at that range, it's still very unlikely to hit. I thought I'd have a punt. Side of the turret on a Conqueror. Should have taken that shot sooner, but I didn't. So there we go. And now there's an IS-7 over there. Oh, Christ. And they're capping with that IS-3. Scoreline is 4-2, though, so that is at least in our favour. And again, I'm far too slow on the uptake. I thought he was going to move forward a bit further. Wanted the gun to be fully aimed, and as a result, I don't get a shot into the Conqueror, but the enemy team does lose their IS-3. And this game is very much just doing what we can in a very awkward situation. See if we can do something about the T-54 away in the distance. Oh, Christ, IS-7. Nope. Bounce. The KV-4's armour is pretty darn good. People say it's irrelevant when people load gold or when you're in a worse matchmaking, but I think it's not as good, obviously, but irrelevant is overstating the problem. Rather. So eventually I'm going to take a hint and I'm just going to load high explosive. There's no point in me trying to penetrate this guy with either my armour piercing or my APCR. APCR would just be a very expensive way to bounce most of my shots. High explosive will be a hilarious way to annoy him. Side of the turret, probably not going to do much, didn't even hit. I mean, the turret on the IS-4 is very tough. These shots are probably not going to do a lot. 62 damage! Oh, fear me. Fear me massively. But he's taking other damage as well. And we're winning 7-2 at this point. This is looking like it might be quite a nice victory for our team. Yeah, missed with that. Just planting a 122mm shell into the ground because, I don't know, I hate worms. Conqueror's dead now, so I don't have to worry about him, but there are still plenty of people capable of putting big fat shots into me and giving me a very bad day indeed. I waste a HE shell there trying to take down the building, which was a bit, with hindsight, was probably a bit dumb, but there we go, never mind. What's done? It's done. IS-7 is looking the other way. While he's distracted, I wonder. You know, because I can also be making his modules feel pain and crew members feel pain and whatnot with these HE rounds. Scoreline is 9-3. Also, the KV-4 is quite heavy, but I can't remember if I try and take advantage of that. 15 damage into the IS-7, but it looks like I might have also knocked his tracks out, which is kind of funny. Yep, he's tracked. IS-7 trying to shoot some other people. Another 67 damage. Blow his tracks off again. Oh, IS-7 is moving. You know what we need to do, lads. We need to do 19 damage. And oh, that one didn't blow his tracks off. Oh, I'm very sad. Very sad indeed. Oh well, let's try again. 25 damage! And it looks like he's tracked. Oh, this guy must just be getting annoyed with me now. I'm just gently tickling him to death. T-34 tries to hurt me, but just damages my tracks. 145 that time! Ooh. Come on, fellas. Put some damage in. Wreck this guy. Wreck him. Oh, he's moving. No! Last HE shell. 10 damage. Blow the tracks off. And he takes like 982 and 371. And he's just in a whole world of trouble. And I'm just going to go for the ram. Because a KV-4 is quite heavy. No! T-30, you spoil sport. I wanted to ram an IS-7 to death. It would have been funny. Damn you. Ah, well, never mind. We managed to pick up something like 1,300 assistance damage on that guy or something stupid. Maybe more. Anyway, 12-7, there's only three of them left. T-34, T-30, and the Object 704. Object is over there, but I don't have a clean shot at him. I don't really have a shot at him at all of any description. He's currently tangling with our Leopard prototype, who hopefully has the best of that engagement, but we shall see. And trundle, trundle, trundle. T-34 off to our right-hand side. I don't really care because so far I have taken zero damage. People have tried to kill me, but they haven't been very successful. Object 704 is dead. We're capping. The T-30 is up on that hill. And our friend Lee Leopard just killed our AMX-5120? I don't really understand that. But, oh well, never mind. Don't get that at all. Not to worry. T-34 and T-30 are the only guys left. T-30 is still up on the hill. T-34 is over there. Can I ninja the kill? Kill successfully ninjured. Now there's just the T-30 up on the hill. Can we do anything to this guy as well? No. Our Tiger 2 deals with him. And there we go. That was the game. Didn't look like I did a fantastic amount, did it? Well, we'll see how well we did. So, second class mastery. What? That was better than I expected. 7 hits on that IS-7 with high explosive, which was funny. Finished off that T-34 and one penetrating hit into the Tiger 2. We did 780 damage. And finished 4th on the team with 839 base experience. Because we got 2,182 assistance damage. Which was quite amusing. We also blocked 1,300 damage with our armour. We took 3 hits, but none of them penetrated. And I almost got a ram kill on an IS-7. So, stock KV-4, tier 10 game, big wide open map. Yeah, you can still do alright. That was quite good fun. Alright, let's move on to the last game of this compilation. Here we go with game number 3. I am driving the A-44. This is the Tier 7, or one of the Tier 7 Soviet medium tanks. This is my first ever game in the A-44. I'd either free XP'd the suspension or was using the enhanced suspension module. I can't remember which. I think I've used free XP. So I've got the stock turret with 1,000 health, but I am using the 107mm gun, the top gun. There isn't actually that much on this tank to unlock. I'm platooned up with British B and Captain Cyan from the SIG clan. British is in his KV-3 and Cyan is in his SU-122-44. So like I said, first ever game in this tank. I don't really know what I'm doing in it. I have heard it has respectably good armour, big derpy gun, is fairly mobile. Okay. And the gun depression sucks. So with all that in mind, I'm going to go to the town, pretend I'm a mobile heavy tank, and beat the snot out of whatever I come across. That at least is the plan. We'll see how well it works out. So far, we've got quite a disconcerting number of people going to the central road. I mean, people like an M6, a Churchill 1. I get that they're not top tier, but... oh dear. Leaving me, a T-34-85... to go to the town. Now, British is also on his way to the town in his KV-3, but KV-3s are not renowned for their speed and mobility, so it will take him a little while. So this gun is the same gun you get on the T-150, 167 penetration, 300 alpha damage, making it the highest alpha damage anti-tank gun to be mounted on a Tier 7 medium tank, which is quite nice. But it's not very accurate. Let's leave it at that. So, Captain Cyan originally went to the central road and has then gone, well, none of you are spotting anything, yeah, screw that, I'm going somewhere else. And British has finally made it into the town. Enemy E-25 has been spotted on that central road, but we've found nothing in the town so far. So far, nothing particularly exciting is happening. There's that E-25. Can I possibly get a shot on this guy? I take the punt, but no. And we're 0-3 down, by the way. We have just lost a trio of bottom-tier tanks. Hoorah! Alright, so screw this. We need to make our presence felt. I should point out at this point that British in his KV-3. His KV-3 is not fully upgraded. And, of course, Cyan's in the SU. I mean, that thing... it's a premium tank, so fully upgraded or not, it's an irrelevant question. BDR G1B, Tier 5 heavy tank. He is also not fully upgraded. This is just a game full of people driving stock tanks, isn't it? Is the T-34 going to get the kill? Probably. Captain Cyan nails the T-34-85, and I actually nail the BDR. And that's the town cleared through. Yeah, they didn't really send many people there. I don't really know why. The valley, however, is looking rather dubious. And hello, there goes the Panzer IV H. Now there's a Hellcat. Captain Cyan deals with the Hellcat. Artillery has been spotted, and there's also a VK-3002M here. And gun depression, gun depression, gun depression. T-34 is blocking my shot. And our artillery nails their Hummel. Oh, Tog nails Captain Cyan, which is unfortunate. He was having a good game. So, speaking of the Tog, let's put some shots into him. Now this is at range, alas. We put one in for 285, and he only damages my tracks. Scoreline is 5-7, and they are at our base, which is worrying. And so I'm looking at the map going, oh well, crud. Let's head back to base then. We went to this effort to get through the town. Now we're going to have to turn around. British isn't really fast enough to be in much of a position to do that. Alas. Stop to take a punt at the Tog, I think. Nope, Tiger. There we go. I land a shot and British polishes him off. Scoreline is 6-8. I really should be going back to the base. I don't know why I'm faffing around with this T-67 and the Tiger, to be honest. I'm relying on other people to do it. Never rely on other people. Other people suck. Do it yourself. Oh, they have stopped capping. Are they not interested in the cap? Do they just want to envelop us and kill us? Ho ho ho! E-25! Up the wazoo! Ram him to death for another 103. Now I'm exposing myself to a bit of fire from people here, but I want this E-25 dead. He's a very dangerous tank in this matchup. TOG takes out my tracks, and so I'm going to get the hell out of here. I take a second shot from the TOG. Don't really want to take any more. That one just damages my tracks, thankfully. And now they're back to capping our base. TOG puts one into my front. I bounce a shot. And that one hopefully went straight into Monsieur TOG. So our Hellcat and artillery are actually doing a bang-up job of keeping the base not capped. And there's a Chinookai also heading back to do something about them. So far between us, our platoon have 5 kills, which is nice. T-43, wait for this gun to aim, takes long enough, and wait, and wait, and wait, and side of the turret, there we go. Slightly high damage roll, which was nice. Hellcat really needs some assistance against that T-43, so if I have another shot, I'm going to try and take it. Really want to close the distance with him, though. Take a shot on the move, alas, it doesn't do the business, and the scoreline is now 12-12. So, we've got myself, British B, and that Chinookai, who's racked up 3 kills in a tier 7 game, so well played to him. They've got this T-43, who is now on rather low health, the TOG and the T-67, who are both over by their base. T-43 is not looking at me because of reasons, and he's going to regret that as I finish him off for kill number 3. And now it's just the T-67 and the TOG on the enemy team. So just going to speed this up a little bit until we get back into the action. Whee! Zooming through the town. And I'm taking a slightly roundabout route to get back because I don't just want to run straight into a TOG and T-67 machine gunning me to death. That would be bad. So, we know where they last were spotted. The Chinookai is going down the valley. British is still on the outskirts of the town. And there's the TOG. TOG is looking at British. Struggling with the gun depression. T-67 nails our Chinookai. Wait for this gun to aim. And bounce. not because the TOG's armoury is any good, but because my accuracy sucks. TOG bounces on me with one shot. Penetrates with the next. He penetrates me. I penetrate him. And I was thinking, this thing's supposed to have good frontal armor. Maybe it's not as good as I was led to believe. And can we kill the TOG? Yes, we can. Also managed to avenge Captain Cyan into the bargain. But we're down to 247 health. Got the 4th kill. We want to find that T-67. Wherever he is. You could argue that I should probably load high explosive at this point, because the HE ammo on this gun does 360 average damage, which would probably one-shot the T-67. But I didn't. I'm not really sure why I didn't. And the Hellcat saying, go and chase down the T-67. I really couldn't be bothered at this point. He bounces on me, I bounce on him. He will reload sooner than I will and do me damage. Now, I was not expecting, yes, our KV-3 is stock, that to be the case. I flub the second shot. Bounce that one. And this is looking a little bit dodgy. He bounces again and I manage to kill him for kill number 5. And there we go. That was the game. So remember, first game I'd ever played in that tank. I didn't play it perfectly at all by any stretch of the imagination. I made some pretty obvious mistakes, including not really going back to base to defend. But let's see how well we did anyway. So that was First Class Mastery, Fire for Effect, Fighter, Master Gunner, Duelist, Bruiser, is that Spartan, I think, and High Caliber, which was quite nice. Also completed a mission at the time, which was also shiny. Between the platoon, we managed 8 kills. I got 3,219 damage, 5 kills, 1,231 base experience. Pretty sweet. We blocked 980 damage with our armor, Fired 19 shots, hit 14, penetrated 13 for that damage count. Got 171 assistance damage, woo. And again, it was a times 5 experience. Weak end, so that was quite a lot of XP there, which was good. Without a premium account, would have made just shy of 19,000 credits profit. With the premium account, it was 34,500 credits. So there we go. A rundown in kind of stock, not fully upgraded, tanks. Just to show you something a little different. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please feel free to catch some of my other videos and or subscribe to my channel. And I wish you very happy hunting on that battlefield. Ciao, ciao.